Bowling Green's Lindsay Austin on Wednesday. This buzzer beater bounced West out of the gun, and in the semis, she sent Miami packing. Today, they hope to bounce Eastern Michigan out of this tournament, but the Eagles also have their eyes on the prize. Ryan Coleman hopes to be cutting down the nets later today in the MAC Women's Tournament Finals. Bowling Green and Eastern Michigan, next.
It's a beautiful sun-splash day in Cleveland. We are at the Gund Arena for the finals of the 2004 Kraft MAC Women's Basketball Tournament. Our participants today, the Falcons of Bowling Green State University and the Eagles of Eastern Michigan. Here's a look at the route our two finalists took to today's Titanic Tournament matchup. Bowling Green took out the top seed in the tournament, Miami, in the semifinal round, while Eastern Michigan dispatched Marshall in the Final Four yesterday. Well, hi there. Dave Weekly with Debbie Leonard this afternoon. Debbie, the Bowling Green Falcons have not been in the finals since 1994. They're 6-0 lifetime in the finals. They think they're a team of destiny, and the way Lindsay Austin's playing, who can blame them? But Eastern Michigan is trying to... They've got plans today, too.
Absolutely, Dave. You know, this Eastern Michigan team is well-coached. It's a very efficient basketball team, and they are ready to accept the MAC's invitation to the big dance.
Well, you got to have seniors. You got to have defense. If you want to win a championship, of both these teams have fabulous freshmen, too.
Absolutely. These are the two youngest basketball teams in the Mid-American Conference, and you're looking at the reason there on the screen that the Mid-American may be the league of the future. Let's talk about Allie Mann first. This young lady is the freshman of the year in the Mid-American. So versatile with her athletic ability. She can shoot the outside shot, love to play tough on the interior. Allie Mann is a real worker, but not even can't display this young kid right here without talking about her work ethic as well. Great on the three-point shot, loves to mix it up with the big girls on the interior.
We're set to cap a terrific week of women's tournament basketball here in Cleveland, but only one team can win this championship this afternoon. We'll tip it up from the gun. Eastern Michigan and Bowling Green, next.
You are definitely paying. Now, get the checkbook.
Ohio Edison and the Illuminating Company, First Energy Companies, have a new idea. Let the mouse pay your electric bill. Ohio Edison and the Illuminating Company introduce online bill payment. Now you can pay your bill over the internet anytime. No checks, no stamps, just the click of a mouse.
Did you already lick this stamp?
Go to firstenergycorp.com today and let the mouse pay your electric bill.
No, we do not need a new mouse pad.
Thanks, Mom.
My kids play hard. That's why they love Capri Sun Sports. It helps rehydrate to keep them going. So after this, they can carry their own stuff.
Capri Sun Sport. It's liquid fuel.
Isn't it nice how we all bring a little something different to the table? Crystal Light. 14 refreshing flavors, just 5 calories. Enjoy life one sip at a time.
Yes, one of rock's most influential bands. Returns to celebrate 35 years of groundbreaking music. Saturday, May 8th at the Palace of Auburn Hills. The Ultimate Yes 35th Anniversary Collection Double CD, along with a new DVD documentary, Yes Speak. Stores now. Tickets are on sale now. Don't miss Yes. Brought to you by Budweiser True Music.
Today's presentation of the Kraft MAC Women's Tournament Championship game is brought to you by Huntington Banking Investments Insurance, by First Energy, our energy is working for you, GMAC, the financial services people from General Motors, by Office Max, you supply the ambition, we'll supply everything else, by Kraft, the title sponsor of the 2004 Kraft MAC Women's Basketball Tournament, MBNA, the official credit card of the MAC, by the Cleveland Clinic, and by Giant Eagle. Make every day taste better. We're inside the Gund Arena in Cleveland, Ohio. This is the finals of the Kraft MAC Women's Basketball Tournament. Bowling Green and Eastern Michigan set to get it on in just a moment. Let's check our MBNA starting lineups for this afternoon's championship game, the winner of which will go to the NCAA tournament for Bowling Green. Those fabulous freshmen up front, Mann, Thorburn, and Honegger, Wenzel, and Austin, a pair of seniors in the backcourt. And for Eastern Michigan, up front, Knapp and Olker, a three-guard lineup for Susie Merchant. Crandall, the three-point specialist. Ford will run the point. Coleman, well, she'll do just about anything she needs to do to win a big game. Lots of intensity. Glad you could join us. Bowling Green, they have been in the finals six times. They have won all six. This is their first appearance since 1994. Eastern Michigan in their first finals. Ryan Coleman with an open look. That might show a little bit of the nerves. Both teams with some butterflies as we begin our game. And Debbie, just off the top, championship memories, Kurt Miller. These girls are going to remember this game the rest of their lives. They're going to be building memories today. And sometimes the nerves pop up early in the game.
Absolutely so. You know that there are young kids out here, and those kids, these freshmen we're talking about right now, are really ready to play this game. Probably the most nervous people on the floor are the seniors and the two coaches.
Yep.
They're really, they're uptight. They're really wanting this game to start. I talked to both coaches before, and they said, this is the longest hour before the game that I've ever spent.
Lindsay Austin, the star of the two previous games here in the gun, and the steal by Coleman.
He won't miss this one. Yes, he will.
She missed two layups to start this game. Allie Mann.
Unbelievable.
Comes up with the steal.
Unbelievable. Now let's see if Bowling Green can get it back to them here. Eastern Michigan playing the man-to-man defense today. Yesterday, Dave, they set back in a zone defense against the Thundering Herd from Marshall and relied on that all afternoon long, but they are a man-to-man club. I think we'll see them switching up a lot this afternoon, however.
There's Austin inside. That shot was partially blocked. Olker, the rebound for Eastern Michigan.
But you see exactly what Bowling Green wants to do. Erica Ford, number 14, the point guard from Eastern Michigan, had an outstanding basketball game yesterday against the Thundering Herd. You know, Marshall plays very, very physically. Ford never lost her composure in that game. If Bowling Green could post her up, get her in some foul trouble, Eastern Michigan would be in trouble all the way around.
Ford with 9 points and five assists in yesterday's semifinal victory over Marshall. Ford gets it up and in the hoop right before the shot clock expired, and Eastern Michigan draws first blood, 2-0.
And I just want to say a little bit more about this kid, Ford. Ryan Coleman, certainly an outstanding player. Sarah Van Meter, we know what she can do as a freshman. But Ford, she's the heart and soul. She's the glue.
Honegger can't hit inside. She nearly had a double-double yesterday in the win over Miami. 10 points, 9 rebounds. Olker all the way to the basket. Puts it up and in with a right hand. Eastern Michigan with a 4-0 lead.
And Olker, the entire season long, has really not been that much of an outstanding offensive performer. If Susie Merchant can get some points out of her early, ooh, that's icing on the cake.
Honegger, pass inside, intended for Mann, slapped away by Knapp. Here comes Coleman. She missed her first two shots, goes down the lane, aggressively to the basket, and draws the foul. Well, Susie Merchant is in her sixth season as the head coach at Eastern Michigan, and this is her first trip to the finals, although she did go to the finals one time as a point guard at Central Michigan in 1991 and came up a loser to Bowling Green.
Susie Merchant, a no-nonsense type coach. Her team, they keep their composure the entire game. And you're going to see, I think, a team this afternoon that's going to stick with their game plan. When you look at Bowling Green, points off defense, so important for them, and timing the runs. We know Bowling Green's going to have runs. They're going to have droughts, but if they can time the run at the right point in time in this particular game, they might come away with the upset.
All right, we'll see how that goes as we move along with our craft keys to the game. We'll check our craft keys for Eastern Michigan in just a moment. Honegger to Mann, turns on Knapp. And that's an offensive foul on Allie Mann. Our Eastern Michigan keys brought to us by Kraft today.
Susie Merchant and the Eastern Michigan squad, they've got to handle the run that you know Bowling Green's going to have. When Bowling Green has one of these spurts, buddy, they're tough to stop. So Eastern Michigan will have to handle that, and they're going to have to rebound the basketball. One and done for Bowling Green if Eastern Michigan wants to win.
BG's missed their first four shots from the field. Here's an opportunity for Eastern to create a little bit of a lead early in the game. Crandall's shot is blocked out of bounds. 16 on the shot clock.
Talk about Marion Crandall, the only senior on this Michigan Eastern Michigan team, I should say. This young lady started out as a walk-on, earned her scholarship, and has really come on so strongly the last 3 weeks of the season for Susan Merchant.
Both these teams with 21 wins right now. Bowling Green 21-9, Eastern Michigan 21-7. Alter, right in front of the rim, could not knock down her second field goal of the first half.
And you could see on that particular play, Alter just not real positive with the basketball. You know, if you want to go to the hoop, you got to go strongly.
Wenzel. And the ball belongs to Eastern Michigan. So Bowling Green with a little bit of the nerves. And for Kurt Miller yesterday, his seniors in the backcourt, Lindsay Austin, Stephanie Wenzel, they were very quiet in the first half before they were gangbusters in the second half. They combined for 36 points in their upset of top-seeded Miami after halftime.
Well, when you play three freshmen as much as Kurt Miller plays three freshmen, you've got to have two outstanding seniors. And Austin and Wenzel, you can't ask for more from those two young ladies.
Ryan Coleman, that shot was blocked. Horn got a piece of that. Now Bowling Green, they've had turnovers on their last three possessions. We'll see what happens here. Man, great ball fake. Takes it to Knapp. And the rebound touched by Coleman, collected by Mann. Got it up to the rim. She's fouled and will have an opportunity to get Bowling Green on the board from the free throw line.
Well, we can tell the officials are going to let the ladies play this afternoon, and that's a good thing because that's what will happen to the team that wins and goes to the NCAA tournament. That time, Allie Mann really stuck with things. We talked about the fact that nobody's going to outwork this young lady except maybe Van Meter from Eastern Michigan.
Mann really, Debbie, came back strong yesterday in the semifinal round after some shaky moments in the quarterfinal victory over Western Michigan, a game in which she had 8 turnovers. She was 8 of 12 from the field in the semifinals, 21 points. So Bowling Green is on the board, and the Falcons with a little token pressure, full court of the full court variety.
They like to play that 2-2-1 quarter court defense just to slow the ball down a bit, and they'll go back to the zone. Right now they're playing their point zone that they play so well under Kurt Miller.
Ford thought about a three, and a 3-second violation on the Eagles. We are up and running in the Kraft Mac Women's Basketball Tournament Championship. Susie Merchant and Eastern Michigan leading Bowling Green 5-2.
I promise you good service when you come into the bank every time. I promise that you're going to be a happy customer when you're banking at Huntington. Those are the little things that I think that set us apart. You can trust me. I will take care of your transaction.
Come on in, sit down. Let's check it out and see what we can do for you. I'm a heck of a good listener.
I think that's what makes me a good banker because I look at them as a person. I want you to feel that I'm your financial partner. We're there for you. So come on into Huntington and be my partner.
I'm not just a Giant Eagle employee, I'm part of the community.
It makes me very proud that Giant Eagle supports the community.
You're out there making a difference, that's great.
At Giant Eagle, we're all family.
We were able to contribute 6,000 computers.
12,998 playground balls.
5 million pounds of food.
I love giving back.
Not just once a year, but all year.
I am proud to help at school.
And I care about my neighborhood.
And I'm proud to work for a company that believes the same thing.
I sleep with it, I bathe with it. You couldn't get me to take it off.
It's just remarkable, actually.
Oh, I think it's very attractive.
It's incredible. It's awesome.
Join the thousands of Q-Ray wearers who simply rave about their revolutionary Q-Ray ionized bracelet.
I am astounded, excited.
You ain't getting this thing back.
Pick up the phone and order your own Q-Ray right now for 3 easy payments of only $49.95. Try it risk-free for 30 days and see for yourself what all the talk is about.
I think it's terrific.
I was amazed.
And it's built tough enough for me. I love my Q-Ray.
But wait, call to order now and Q-Ray will even make one payment for you. That's a savings of nearly $50 off the regular price.
I would absolutely recommend the Q-Ray IMF bracelet. 100%. No question about it.
Find out for yourself why everyone is wearing a Q-Ray.
And I'm so excited. I can't believe it.
I'm a believer.
You've got to get a Q-Ray. So call to order your Q-Ray ionized bracelet right now.
Just underway, this is the Kraft Mac Women's Tournament Final. Eastern Michigan with an early lead. And for Bowling Green, Lindsay Austin has been the story here in Cleveland. That was the shot that knocked Western Michigan out of the quarterfinals. Western Michigan was the defending champ of this tournament. Then yesterday, Austin took aim on the top seed, Miami. Another buzzer beater, 75-74. In fact, she's had 3 buzzer-beating shots this year, 2 against Western Michigan, 1 against Miami. And she had her hands on the ball for a desperation three that did not go in when Eastern Michigan and Bowling Green met last back on January 27th.
And you know, in talking with Kurt Miller before this basketball game, he discussed the fact that if his team could play anybody in the tournament, they really wanted to finally get a matchup again with Eastern Michigan. You see Horns coming to the game. She's so strong, can hit the three, but another one of those real versatile players for Bowling Green. But get back to the point that Bowling Green wanted Eastern Michigan. They think that's a game that they just let slip by them, and they don't like that fact.
Horn, another one of those fabulous freshmen that just seemed to come off the BG bench and wave. And Ford knocks down a three for Eastern Michigan.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Eastern Michigan wins this tournament. People have got to look at Erica Ford as the MVP. No, she doesn't have all those high numbers and everything, but has she led this team or what?
You can see where BG has struggled from the field in the early going. Wenzel down the lane. The academic All-American could not hit. She goes sprawling into the lane, and Ryan Coleman back the other way. Coleman off to a bit of a slow start offensively. Here's Crandall, one of the best three-point shooters in the nation. Olker on the low block. Turns, puts it up and in with the left hand this time. Debbie, she scored two baskets with the right. Now she comes back the other way with the left.
It's pretty huge. I thought the team that established themselves in the post early, not with the post coming outside and hitting the three-point shots, but the post in the paint early might be the team that wins the whole thing. Now, what Bowling Green's got to do, since the ball's going into the post so easily, look for the guards from Bowling Green to start doubling down, digging that ball out, and let's see if Olker can then become a good passer as much as she's been a good shooter so far.
Honiger back in. Katfer takes the seat on the BG bench. Sarah Van Meter, the sixth man of the year in the Mid-American Conference, now on the floor for the first time for Eastern Michigan.
Away from the basket. I'm sure Susie Merchant wants to get her back inside. Dive down. Oh, no. She's going to take three as well.
Olker's feeling it in this final. Back iron had the shot online, and the foul is going to be on Van Meter.
Well, you're going to feel it. I'm sure Susie Merchant would like her to feel it down around the block a little bit more than up at the top of the key.
48th meeting between these two teams. First meeting ever was back in 1977. BG with a huge edge in the all-time series, 36-11, but Eastern Michigan's won two out of the last three. Allie Mann, what a great move. Went right around Olker and put it up and in.
And a good pass by Wenzel on that play. Stephanie Wenzel really telling the freshman, hey, go back door. Bowling Green back to the zone now. They're both teams are going to see them switch up, go between the 2-3 zone where they trap a lot out of that one, and this point defense that they love to trap baseline.
Now Ford sent that one into the crowd for a turnover.
And look at Wenzel saying, hey, get back door on this play, girl. Go, go. And there goes the freshman learning from the senior. Nice finish there, Miss Mann.
Debbie, yesterday in the semifinals, Marshall was really frustrated by Eastern's 2-3 zone. What are they going to try to do defensively today against Bowling Green?
Well, as we talked about, they're going to switch things up. They're a man-to-man team, but Susie Merchant and her squad knows that if you play just one defense in this game, Kurt Miller's going to find a way to beat you. So you'll see them going between man zone, full court pressure. We'll see it all. Hey, you got to see it all. As you see Wenzel going to the basket strongly, this senior knows, hey, this could be my last trip because if Bowling Green does happen to lose this basketball game, they do have a slight chance, though, to get into that WNIT. WNIT's got to look at a 21-game winner.
Knapp back on the floor. Olker, following that foul, will take a seat. You know, Debbie, that's really a good point because we got two teams today, both of them with 21 wins, and you know, the Mid-American Conference has been a much stronger conference this year in women's basketball, all the way up to 12th as a league in the RPI, up from 19th just two seasons ago.
Well, credit the coaches for that. They've really improved their scheduling. They're scheduling the tougher teams. And like I said in the open, you know, this is a league of youth.
Yep.
And it's maybe the league of the future. There are so many great freshmen in this league.
We'll check our all-freshman team and the other all-tournament selections, all-conference picks, rather, at halftime. Here's Ryan Coleman. No, that was Williams off the bench. She was quiet yesterday in the semifinals, but she hits her first shot tonight.
Camille Williams said, hey, okay, if you don't want to trap me on that play, just shape up here and hit the three.
Williams had only 3 points yesterday against Marshall, and she hits her first shot. That's a good sign for Eastern Michigan. And here she comes with a basketball right now. She is instant offense.
Senior on freshman in that particular play, Lindsay Austin with the height advantage, the wingspan there. She's got to get up and play a little bit tighter on Miss Williams.
Eastern Michigan has led all the way. They enjoy a 5-point edge right now.
Bowling Green doing a good job. There's a nice screen, though, by the freshman, Van Meter.
Well, Crandall couldn't get the runner to go down the lane, and the rebound by Wenzel. Horn unmarked to the hoop, and she'll go to the line for two.
Well, the senior Crandall tries to get involved in that play, and not really good transition defense at all for Eastern Michigan on that squad. Bowling Green loves to run head up. Lindsay Austin says, hey, let's get a little action going here, and Horn says, yes, I'd be happy to take it to the hoop for you. You see the senior Crandall getting in late, getting the foul.
Horn back iron, no good. One more free throw to come for the freshman from Lima Senior High School. She had 28 points against Northern Illinois in the regular season. Lewis comes into the game. Austin will take a seat and get a couple of extra seconds rest because we've got a television time out coming right now. 11:54 to go, first half. MAC Women's Tournament Championship game. Eastern Michigan leads Bowling Green by 4.
So good.
Maybe you should go home.
Highlighters and everything else you need to do your thing at Office Max.
Hey, what do you mean it didn't work?
He didn't believe me.
As Cleveland's number one sports health provider, Cleveland Clinic Sports Health is on a first-name basis with some of Cleveland's most promising athletes. Cleveland Clinic Sports Health. Who says you have to be a pro to be treated like one?
They're going to work. Fox 2's Dan Miller, Greg Kelser from Fox Sportsnet, and the Detroit Pistons. They're warmed up and ready.
My favorite sports tale about basketball legend Dan Miller.
It's fiction.
It's celebrity story time for the Detroit Pistons Read to Achieve program. Come to the Cat and Gardner White on Saturday, March 13th at 3 for stories from Detroit Piston Richard Hamilton, plus your Fox 2 favorites. Call 248-395-FOX2 or visit our website.
I am so hungover.
And you've got to be at work in an hour.
How come you feel so good? You drank more than I did.
I took Chaser, remember?
Chaser?
Chaser tablets. You take them right after you start drinking, and you're guaranteed never to get a hangover.
Chaser is clinically proven, safe, and effective. It absorbs hangover-causing toxins like a sponge, so you can wake up feeling alert and energetic, not hungover.
Looks like you should have taken Chaser, too.
Buy Chaser today at GNC, Walgreens, and these other fine stores.
13-9, Eastern Michigan leads Bowling Green. 11:54 to go in the first half. This is the finals of the Kraft MAC Women's Tournament Championship. Well, Kurt Miller in his third season, and meanwhile back in the crowd, the man they call the Pope of Bowling Green women's basketball, Fran Ball, in the house. And you can see he won 4 MAC championships and also spent some time as the women's head coach at Central Michigan, and now Kurt Miller takes the reins at Bowling Green, and he's got the Falcons in the finals for the first time in a decade. It's the first time since 1988 we've had 2 teams from the state of Michigan in the finals.
Well, nice change of direction from Kania Miller on that particular play, and takes a tenacious defender in Tanae Lewis to the basket.
Lewis, number 24, with the mask. Horn up top, guarded by Coleman. Horn down the lane, put it up with a right hand, too strong. Williams, you know she always wants to push it. Ahead to Coleman.
Nikki Knapp, one of the post players that they're not going to guard on the outside for sure. There's the double down we talked about. It's going to come from the perimeter players doubling down in the post there, but can't foul on that play.
Horn whistled on the personal. You know, Debbie, this is the championship game of the MAC tournament. Where's Kent State? Where's Toledo? Where's the defending champion, Western Michigan? The fact that we've got Eastern Michigan in this championship for the first time and Bowling Green in the finals for the first time since 1994 really has given this game kind of a little bit of an odd energy. There's some very interesting vibes going through the gun today.
When I talk to my coaching friends around the country, and they'll say, "Oh, you're doing MAC games, so I guess how's Kent and Toledo doing?"
Yeah.
And that's all. And I'm like, "Hey, it's no longer a Mark Elon and Bob Lindsay don't have the easy road anymore. A lot of parity in the Mid-American Conference."
Eastern Michigan with their largest lead of the game at 8 points right now. Wenzel for three. She hit 4 threes yesterday. Horn had her hands on the rebound, but lost out to Williams.
Oh, the mistake of bringing the ball down after the rebound comes back to haunt you. Jump ball.
17-9, 10:45 to go in the first half. Well, this is a big day. The Kraft Macaroni and Cheese promotion. Purchase 2 5-pack boxes of Kraft Mac and Cheese at your local Giant Eagle. Bring them on down here to the gun right now and get a voucher for tonight's men's championship game. Those 2 5-pack boxes of mac and cheese will be donated to the Harvest for Hunger. And it's a pretty good deal if you want to get a ticket for the men's final tonight. Should be a terrific game. Kent State and Western Michigan.
Good job. Recognition there. Bowling Green, that particular time, saw the dribble pick it up and not have anybody to go to. A lot of players moving towards the basketball, as you see. Hey. There's too much time on the clock for Lindsay Austin to be hitting action.
Yeah, but you know what? She needs to start making some shots because Bowling Green is down by 8. And now they've been a team that they've missed their last 5 field goal attempts from the field. But, you know, they can't keep coming back. They need to keep contact with Eastern Michigan.
Well, I think they can do that. Remember, at one point yesterday, it was 40-25. Miami over Bowling Green, and they came back very strongly. Again, they're a team of runs. They have the droughts. If you're a team that has a lot of runs, a lot of spurts, you're going to have those droughts that go along with it.
A 15-0 run in the second half against Miami. Honegger with the miss, Coleman the rebound.
Remember from yesterday, it was Honegger who came in and hit the three and really got things going for Bowling Green to start their run to come back in the game.
Knapp. Oh, great feed inside. Van Meter with the finish.
Just not good communication that time defensively for Bowling Green. The screen's being set outside. It was a really good screen. The Bowling Green players got mixed up. Nobody recovered to the basket.
So Kurt Miller needs a timeout. Hey, Mac fans, go along with the MBNA Mac MasterCard. Call toll-free 1-866-GET-MBNA now to apply for Mac MasterCard and get a Mac Spectator chair free with your first qualifying transaction of at least $25. Call toll-free 1-866-GET-MBNA. Be sure to mention that priority code that we've been discussing all season, QJQ4, because, Debbie, without that priority code, this does not work.
I know that. By this time, I know that.
Our Eastern Michigan in the midst of a 6-0 run. Over the last 2 minutes and 15 seconds.
Eastern Michigan is such an efficient basketball team. If there's one word to describe them, that's it, efficient. If there's a word to describe this Bowling Green team, I'd have to pick resilient. I mean, they can come back, and look what they're going to do. A little one-on-one here. Miss Austin taking it to the hoop.
Now, Bowling Green now really continuing to struggle from the field. They have missed 15 of their first 17 shots here in this championship game.
There's the screen again. They're doing a really good job with the on-ball screens out front. Bowling Green, again, better communication is required.
Knapp trying to work on Honegger in the low post, up and under. A great move, just couldn't finish. Allie Mann, the rebound for Bowling Green. Boy, Bowling Green, ugly stuff offensively. 6 turnovers and only 2 field goals. Wenzel forces her way inside, too strong on the attempt. Knapp the rebound for Eastern Michigan. So the Eagles now with a double-digit lead and a chance to build on it.
And, Dave, you talk about Wenzel. You know, we've seen her take the ball, and there's Ryan Coleman. Great job on that three-point shot. If she can square those shoulders, she can shoot with anyone in the league. We said she might be the best player in the MAC, or at least has the potential to do that if she'll keep that switch on the own position next season, all season long. But Stephanie Wenzel has not taken a three-point shot yet in this basketball game. She's been driving the ball to the basket. Need to rely on the offensive sets that Kurt Miller has in his repertoire here. Use them a little more, set some good screens, and some three-point opportunities.
Thorburn couldn't knock down the three. BG's missed their last nine field goal attempts. Here's Knapp. And Eastern Michigan is rolling. It's 24-9 as we turn under 8 minutes to go in the first half.
And they're such an efficient ball club with a fine leadership on the team that it'll be a little tougher for Bowling Green to come back against them, I think, than any other team in the MAC for that matter.
Well, Allie Mann has four of Bowling Green's first 9 points, and she took it upon herself to drive hard to the basket, and she'll go to the free throw line for two. What a great impact player for Bowling Green. Maybe the best of the group of freshmen for Kurt Miller. Freshman of the year in the MAC.
Well, and you see in that particular free throw, see how she came out of it so quickly? Allie, you got to stay in that shot. You got to hold that follow through up there, lady. Use those knees in the free throws.
Horn back on the floor. Wenzel and Thorburn will take a seat. BG's gone over 6 minutes without a field goal. Mann.
Better technique and gets the roll.
One of two. Well, the start of this championship game has been dominated by Eastern Michigan. Bowling Green with some work to do. They trail by 14 at the gun.
Imagine a financial services company that's driven to make the world a better place. From the family next door to the person on the next continent. From your car to your home to your business. And everything in between. We're GMAC. Imagine how we can help you change your world.
The MAC is back, and an automatic bid to the 2004 NCAA tournament is on the line as MAC Madness returns to Cleveland's Gund Arena March 10th through the 13th. Tournament tickets are on sale now at the Arena Box Office through Ticketmaster or any MAC school. 18, 7 games, 1 goal. MAC Madness at the gun. Be there.
Regrow dense natural hair safely and effectively, free with Easy Hair.
Your products have brought about results in less than 3 weeks.
In less than 2 months, I've seen results on my head. Makes it feel good. Feel real good.
Easy Hair blends 3 proven formulas to produce larger, healthier hair follicles. A free volumizing shampoo that removes dirt and unclogs hair roots and follicles. A free clinically tested and proven medicated solution that increases the blood supply to your undernourished follicles. And a free herbal DHT blocker, a chemical found in large quantities only in balding men, so you can resume your natural hair growing process. There's no better or easier way to regrow your hair, and it's free. Easy Hair is giving away a full 4-month supply of our proven hair growth system. That's a free bottle of our specially formulated volumizing shampoo. A free bottle of our clinically tested and proven hair regrowth solution, and a free bottle of our herbal DHT blocker capsules. That's a savings of up to $40 per month for 4 full months. That's a whopping $160 value, free. A thicker, fuller head of hair is only a phone call away, but you must act now. Regrow your lost hair free with Easy Hair. Call now.
Everybody is officially credentialed for this game. Eastern Michigan by 14, 24-10. Eastern Michigan, Debbie, doing some great interior passing.
Well, we know they're an efficient ball club, great passing team, and you see, if you're a great passing team, probably means somewhere you're setting good screens as well, and Knapp loves to take it inside. Eastern Michigan just doing a good job so far in this game, but Susie Merchant knows that Bowling Green will come back, and her team will have to withstand a run at some point.
Eastern Michigan with the big edge for Susie Merchant in the points in the paint category. We got a little bit of a sense of the Eagles, or the E-Gals, great interior passing yesterday in their semifinal win over Marshall.
Exactly. Bowling Green deciding, hey, you know, we might as well just go to back to our point zone here, see if we can get something out of it, because the screens are really hurting us when we're in man-to-man.
Now Coleman fires up an air ball, has a chance for BG to get a little closer. They trail by 14. Lindsey Austin, the star of the previous two tournament games here at the Gund, scoreless, starting the game 0-for-4 from the field.
See, on that particular play, the guard can go underneath that screen because they know Austin's not going to use the pull-up jumper. There's the offensive rebounding that we talked about earlier. That's a key for Eastern Michigan. If they let Bowling Green start getting to the offensive board, they're going to be in trouble.
Horn now with 5 points off the bench for the Falcons. Maybe that'll get Bowling Green started a little bit.
Now back to man-to-man once again. Let's see if the screens still work.
dumped down. Van Horn, or Van Meter rather, turns on Allie Mann, can't finish.
Plays it sometimes with Van Horn.
Yeah. Horn spinning, ball tapped away by Coleman. We'll stay at this end, 18 on the shot clock. Olker returns, Van Meter will exit.
Olker really playing great minutes, the first five for Susan Merchant, establishing the post play.
4 points and two rebounds. Honiger. Here's the dump down to Austin, still looking for a first basket until now.
See, that's a play that Kurt Miller, I think, just has got to keep going back to isolate Lindsay Austin down there on the post, not just on Kenia Williams, but also when Erica Ford comes back in the ball game. Yeah, I don't think Olker's going to take another three-pointer up there.
No.
Unless it's desperation. Ooh,
Williams down the lane, off the window, no good. Missed it all with that shot.
Can we run? Can somebody get a transition layup? No. Good job, defensive transition.
BG in the midst of a 7-0 run. As Lewis able to finish. And here come the Falcons. They've cut the lead to single digits at 24-16.
Here's the run. I can tell you one thing. Kurt Miller's got to have a lot of gray hairs this year because, like I said before, when you have the runs, you're going to have the droughts too. But this is the run that Eastern Michigan is just going to have to withstand. Oh, look at Nikki Knapp. Is she strong or what?
I think she was just frustrated because she missed that shot under the basket. She was able to get into a held ball situation. The possession arrow goes the Eagles' way. So the ladies from Ypsilanti will keep possession and a fresh 30 with 5:23 to go in the first half. Kapfer back into the game for Bowling Green. Mann elects it. Crandall in inbound. Ford back on the floor, running the point. Coleman flashes to the ball. Now that shot partially blocked by Horn. Knapp got it up in and draws the foul from Honiger. And a chance for a three-point play.
Well, and there are two of the strongest players in the Mid-American Conference up against each other. And Nikki Knapp, the winner of that particular confrontation.
So Knapp, a sophomore from Blue Springs, Missouri. Second team All-MAC selection.
What a great name. Nikki Knapp.
And Blue Springs, that sounds like there'd be a lot of good fishing there, doesn't it? Well, you can see BG has definitely heated up from the field, but of course, it wouldn't take much to do better than 2 of 17 to start the game. They've hit 3 of the last 4 field goal attempts. They trail by 10.
All 3 of those attempts makes coming in the lane. As you see the ball pass to the player falling down. And good retrieval.
I don't know how Horn got rid of that. And Austin threw it away and then compounded the problem by fouling Coleman.
Yeah, Ryan Coleman, just a good anticipation. Two good athletes up against each other, Lindsay Austin, and there's a little running screen set. And wow, leaving your feet to block the shot or the pass. Ryan Coleman, a good space between there and frustration foul there on the senior.
Wenzel back on the floor for Bowling Green.
And Wenzel, a young lady that Kurt Miller needs to get involved in his offense.
Austin now with 2 personal fouls. So Lindsay's on the bench with 4:51 to go in the first half. Debbie, what do you think? You think we'll see her anymore in the first half?
No, not if you're me as the head coach, but Kurt, I doubt he will make that move either. 10-point deficit again. This is a Bowling Green team that's been coming back all season long, so I'm sure Kurt has confidence right now in Tanae Lewis running the point. And you've got Wenzel out there. She's going to be the steadying force.
Crossover by Coleman, and she lost it out of bounds.
And you get a little help from your friends,
yes,
like dribbling off your foot, and maybe this can be the beginning of something for Bowling Green.
Boy, Austin, though, does so many things for Bowling Green. Not
yes,
only
she
scores,
does.
She triggers the break, she leads the defense, but she's on the bench right now. Here's Lewis, and she immediately throws it away.
Right.
Ford the steal, 2-on-1 back the other way. Ford, great look to Knapp, who put it up and in. How did she see Knapp?
Really nice pass that time again. Can't say enough about the passing ability of this Eastern Michigan team. And Tanae Lewis right now, you know that Ryan Coleman is giving her a lot of headaches out here.
BG had cut the lead to 8. Now it's 12 again. Here's Wenzel for 3.
That's what you need. That's how Stephanie Windsor can get her team back in this game.
First three-pointer of the game for Bowling Green after six misses from outside the arc to start this championship game. Knapp to Olker.
Oh, and just nice cut to the basket. Set the screen, hold that screen just to the right point, and the timing on the release of those players setting the screens and diving to the basket has just been perfect almost for Eastern Michigan this afternoon.
Wenzel hit a three last time she had the ball. Nice lob inside to Horn, and she draws the foul from Olker. That's her second, and Horn's got a chance for a three-point play.
You know, when you look down the lineup for Kurt Miller and his basketball team, you see all these freshmen. The one thing you see is that they are all so versatile. Horn has all the ability in the world to hit the three-point shots. Right here, she gets the nice lob pass, takes the contact, still makes the shot. She's excited, getting her hands up, see if she can complete this old-fashioned three-point play.
Van Meter back into the game. Horn already with a season average. And she completes the three-point play. 3:33 to go in our first half. Bowling Green behind a three-pointer by Stephanie Wenzel, back in the game, trailing by eight. The Eagles, however, have the lead.
The Mid-American Conference and MAC Properties salute all of the corporate partners for their valuable support and commitment. Their belief and participation in Mid-American Conference athletics have helped the league thrive, and we look forward to many years of successful partnership.
You are definitely paying. Now, get the checkbook.
Ohio Edison and the Illuminating Company, First Energy Companies, have a new idea. Let the mouse pay your electric bill. Ohio Edison and the Illuminating Company introduce online bill payment. Now you can pay your bill over the internet anytime. No checks, no stamps, just the click of a mouse.
Did you already lick this stamp?
Go to firstenergycorp.com today and let the mouse pay your electric bill.
No, we do not need a new mouse pad.
How would you like to win four tickets to a Red Wings game, courtesy of Bell Tire? All you have to do is stop by any Bell Tire location and pick up an official Power Play entry postcard. Then tune into Red Wings hockey on Fox Sportsnet. When the Red Wings score a Power Play goal, write down who scored and on what day. Then mail the entry postcard to Bell Tire Power Play Contest, Box 2 Southfield, 48037. One lucky Bell Tire Power Play viewer per month is going to win four tickets to a Red Wings home game. Come on, give it a shot.
It's playoff time in the CCHA, and the winner of this first-round series moves on to the Super 6 next week in the Joe. Great college hockey you won't want to miss. Ferris State, Michigan State, tonight at 7:30 on Fox Sports Net.
Introducing Late Night Poker, the series that all of Europe is talking about, finally comes to the U.S. It's television's only nightly poker series, and it's only on Fox Sports Net.
Eastern Michigan leads by 8, 3:33 to go in the first half of the MAC Women's Tournament Championship game. There's one of the mascots that'll be taking part in mascot basketball at halftime. And he can't wait to get Fred Flintstone in the low block.
Yeah.
That'll be coming up at halftime, along with an interview with Tom Venturella. We'll check our MAC news and notes, and Debbie and I will break down the highlights and the stats of our first half. Susie Merchant and Eastern Michigan. Eastern Michigan in the finals for the first time ever. Bowling Green, Kurt Miller in the finals for the first time since 1994. The Falcons have won six straight. That's their longest winning streak since 1998, but now they find themselves down by eight.
Bowling Green coming out of the timeout into the zone defense. 2-3 zone right now. Good decision by Kurt Miller. Try to keep this run going right now. Last 4 minutes and 10 seconds are 5 of 5 field goal situation. See if they can score again.
Allie Mann leads Bowling Green in rebounding on the season. 8 a game. Flips it up, an air ball, however.
And Allie goes strong to the hoop there. Turn around. Strong to the hoop. Use the backboard on that play, Dave.
Ford had her eye on the basketball the entire way. That's why that was not a turnover. Van Meter with with the pass to Knapp, and Knapp has been busy here in the first half with 8 points, 4-7 from the field.
And once again, it's that opposite pose from the elbow, making that dive down to the block, who gets the pass and lays it in.
Critical time in this game for the Falcons, trying to stay close. They trail by 10 again. Honiger with a nice pick up top. Dorn fires and hits. That's a 2-point goal. She had her foot on the line.
And probably fouled on that play.
That was a knuckleball that went right down the center of the basket.
Maybe she's not fouled, though. The thing doesn't go in. So, you know, give and take.
Crandall still without a 3-point attempt. Wenzel marking Crandall. 5 on the shot clock. Pass inside, stolen by Mann.
Better defense that time again. Out of the zone, it seems like Bowling Green's being much more successful. I'm surprised that they're playing like man-to-man because the screens are certainly working well against them.
You can see that Bowling Green shooting the basketball better following the first 10 minutes of the first half. Fast break by Eastern Michigan. Van Meter can't finish. Wenzel cherry picking, but it was Crandall who deflected the pass. That saved a basket for sure.
A lot of action out here.
Wenzel was wide open, 20 feet beyond the nearest defender, and Crandall was able to deflect that pass. Inside. The foul's on Honiger, and Knapp is going to go back to the free throw line.
And once again, when Bowling Green goes to the man-to-man defense, something good happens for Eastern Michigan.
Boy, you know, just to go back to that last basket that did not happen for Bowling Green, that's a massive turnaround. They make that. It's a 6-point game. Here's the chance if Knapp makes these free throws to push the deficit back to double digits. She misses the first. One more coming for Nikki Knapp. Williams on the floor. Now Coleman will take a seat. So I would imagine Ryan will sit down for the remainder of the first half.
Absolutely. And Lindsey Austin down for almost 5 minutes. Bowling Green to have this deficit in single digits is very, very important.
Inside of a minute to go, first half. Lob pass inside intended for home. Crandall's hands are everywhere. She deflected that ball away.
When you throw the lob, you've got to throw it. You've got to shoot it like a shot. Shoot it up there towards the rim. Don't just pass it directly to the player.
Van Meter crashing the board. Had a hand on an offensive rebound. Couldn't control it.
2-on-3 until everyone else gets back down the floor. Good decision from the senior to hold things up.
Here's Wenzel going to take it all the way to the basket. Couldn't score. For the rebound. About a 1 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock.
Well, that would have been a great possession to run some stuff. Wenzel got the shot, but I'm sure not the shot that Kurt Miller necessarily would have wanted. Would rather have her shaking up there, looking at the basket, hitting that 3-pointer.
Susie Merchant signaling from the bench. Final possession. Eastern Michigan wants to run it down, or do they?
Not a good shot.
Williams just decided to fire up that three. Here's a last chance opportunity for Bowling Green. Got to get to the hoop. Lewis off the rim. No good. There was no scoring at all by either team in the last 2 minutes and 20 seconds of the first half. Knapp heading back to the Eastern Michigan locker room after scoring 8 points in the first half. Kurt Miller and Bowling Green with some work to do. We've reached the break at the MAC Women's Championship game. Eastern Michigan in their first final appearance ever with the lead at the break, 32-24.
Thanks, Mom. My kids play hard. That's why they love Capri Sun Sports. It helps rehydrate to keep them going. So after this, they can carry their own stuff.
Capri Sun Sport. It's liquid fuel.
Isn't it nice how we all bring a little something different to the table? Crystal Light. 14 refreshing flavors, just 5 calories. Enjoy life one sip at a time.
I promise you good service when you come into the bank every time. I promise that you're going to be a happy customer when you're banking at Huntington. Those are the little things that I think that set us apart. You can trust me. I will take care of your transaction. Come on in, sit down. Let's check it out and see what we can do for you. I'm a heck of a good listener. I think that's what makes me a good banker, because I look at them as a person. I want you to feel that I'm your financial partner. We're there for you. So come on into Huntington and be my partner.
I am so hungover.
And you've got to be at work in an hour.
How come you feel so good? You drank more than I did.
I took Chaser, remember?
Chaser?
Chaser Kaplan. take them right after you start drinking, and you're guaranteed never to get a hangover.
Chaser is clinically proven safe and effective. It absorbs hangover-causing toxins like a sponge, so you can wake up feeling alert and energetic, not hungover.
Looks like you should have taken Chaser, too.
Buy Chaser today at GNC, Walgreens, and these other fine stores.
Weeknights, it's a who's who on the best damn sports show, period.
It's back!
It's the clubhouse for Hollywood and Hall of Fame.
Please welcome The Rock, Pamela Anderson, Chris Rock,
Jesse Jackson,
Cuba Gooding Jr.
Where anything can and will happen.
This is too good and too much fun.
Just move your hips in a circle.
That is must-see T-Busy right there.
Weeknights on Fox Sports Net.
So my girlfriend says, hey, let's go to a film festival. And I'm like, film festival? What? So I can hang out with really boring people and drink espresso and use words like noir? But then she's like, no, it's not that kind of film festival where there's no plot. It's the X-Net Film Festival! Action sports, video games, music, film!
Watch the X-Dance Film Festival March 8th to the 14th only on Fuel. To get hooked up with Fuel today, log on at Fuel.tv or call 1-877-4-FUEL-TV.
It's halftime at the Kraft Women's Tournament Championship game of the Mid-American Conference. The Eagles of Eastern Michigan lead 32-24. I'm joined by Tom Vettorello representing Kraft. And Tom, I've found myself in some pretty scary places. But right now we're on the floor in the middle of the mascot game. It's kind of a frightening place to be, wouldn't you agree?
This is absolutely crazy. It's the only way to describe this. Kool-Aid Man actually doesn't have any arms, and he's out here trying to score baskets.
It's frightening. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of the mascots. I mean, Kool-Aid Man is out there. Zippy's out there. Rocket Man. Well, you know, Oreo Man has brought his A game today.
I tell you, Dave, 2 years ago, we were standing in this exact spot, and I almost got taken out by Kool-Aid Man and Rocket Man. My goal is to get out of this interview safe and sound.
Listen, let me just ask you about Kraft's participation in the MAC Women's Basketball Tournament. I think you've planted your flag in a winner.
Well, first let me talk about the two teams that are out there right now. You know, people don't know that both of them won 20 games or more, so they deserve to be here. They're playing their hearts out, and I expect the second half, nobody wants to go home number two. Secondly, the Mid-America Tournament. It's been a first-class act since the first tip-off this week, and I really enjoyed watching it grow in the last 5 years. And lastly, our association with the MAC is just unbelievable. I couldn't ask for anything more on behalf of Kraft.
And of course, we've been talking about it all season long, the Harvest for Hunger. Kraft Mac and Cheese promotion still eligible this afternoon. If you run down and get two of these five packs from a Giant Eagle, bring it down to the gun. You can get a voucher for the men's game tonight.
Two of those five packs will cost you $4, and you can get a free ticket for the MAC men's tournament tonight. That's unbelievable. I got mine yesterday, made my deposit, and I have to tell you, this association, we will have fed over 200,000 meals in the last 5 years. So it's a great promotion. That's what it's all about.
Oh, and there's no question that I think Kraft has gotten great exposure all around the league by this Harvest for Hunger promotion.
Not only Kraft, I want to thank the Mid-America Conference, I want to thank the Gund Arena, and I want to thank Giant Eagle for their participation also.
Tom, congratulations. You've survived the interview, although Barney Rubble was giving you kind of a menacing look a minute ago. Thanks for joining us here at the break. Enjoy the second half.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
We'll be back in just a moment. More from the Gund. We're at halftime. Eastern Michigan leads by 8.
Pick it up.
You know what, dude?
I've had just about enough of you.
I practically carried you up this mountain.
Yeah, right.
Who forgot their water bottle?
Say one more thing.
And you'll do what?
I swear.
Let's see what you got.
Yeah?
Nothing, boy.
Come on. Bring it. Come on.
You see, that's what we need around here. Teamwork. Because remember, nobody succeeds unless everybody succeeds.
Motivational posters and everything else you need to do your thing at Office Max.
Would you like to earn thousands of dollars working just a few hours a week? Would you like to spend more time having fun and less time worrying about money?
Since I started Carlton's course, I've put around $650,000 in cash in my pocket.
We're making a little over $200,000 a year. I'm working 15 hours a week.
It really does work, and it can work for you. Call right now and get my free informational video. You have nothing to lose by learning more about how my no-down-payment real estate investing system can change your life.
And everyone who calls right now will receive Carlton's Financial Freedom Planner, an interactive CD-ROM worth $39.95, yours free. The Financial Freedom Planner has over 80 robust financial calculators to help you understand and track your current financial situation, calculate what-if retirement plans, and much, much more. It's yours free of charge simply for picking up the phone and calling to learn more.
Call the number on your screen right now. Don't miss this limited time offer to secure your financial future. Call now.
We're at halftime. Eastern Michigan leads Bowling Green 32-24 at the MAC Women's Basketball Tournament. The mascot game continues. I'm not sure what Sugar Bear's problem is, but he needs to get his pants up. And there goes the buzzer. Barney Rubble is a beast. I didn't even realize he was out on parole. All right, let's check a little thing we love to do each week. We call it the MAC News and Notes. And here's your player of the year, Casey Ross, with a fabulous year she had for Western Michigan before a season-ending knee injury against Toledo. Averaged almost 20 points a game. And the coach of the year, Maria Fontana Rosa, the Miami Redhawks, won 20 games this season. They were knocked out in a semifinal round of the tournament by Bowling Green. Freshman of the year, you're seeing her on the floor this afternoon, Allie Mann of Bowling Green, averaging almost 13 points a game, and you can see she's on the court for almost 31 minutes per contest this year for the Falcons. The defensive player of the year in the Mid-American Conference, Lindsay Austin. She has just been a terror in this tournament, hit those buzzer beaters to knock out Western Michigan and Miami in the semifinals yesterday. Sarah Van Meter of Eastern Michigan, our sixth man of the year. A big impact for the Eagles as they've clawed their way into the championship game of the tournament for the first time in school history. And to recap, our first team all-conference selections, Ryan Coleman of Eastern Michigan, Colleen Day from Miami, Kate Endress of Ball State, Casey Ross from Western Michigan, and Lindsay Shear of Kent State. Our second team, Andrea Cesar from Kent State, Nikki Knapp from Eastern Michigan in our game today, Kim Lancaster and Sydney Merrill of Miami, and Stephanie Wenzel, the senior guard from Bowling Green. And here's the freshman. This is an athletic group that's going to lead the MAC in the future. Amanda Jackson of Miami, Allie Mann of BG, Carrie Moore of Western Michigan, Stephanie Raymond, the Cat Quick guard from Northern Illinois, and Sarah Van Meter of Eastern Michigan. And how about our academic All-Americans on the first team, Stephanie Wenzel and Kate Endress of Ball State. Congrats. Colleen Day of Miami on the second team, and a third team academic All-American selection, Lindsay Shear of Kent State. Well, thankfully, the mascot game is over. We have cleared the court of those imposters, but we've created memories that will last a lifetime, I think. Unbelievable stuff. I thought they were going to drag my partner Debbie Leonard out onto the court. Oh, my goodness. Is that a precursor of things to come for Bowling Green? Well, they trail by eight here at the break, 32-24. Debbie Leonard will rejoin me in a moment. We'll check the highlights and stats of the first half of our championship game in just a moment. Before Eastern Michigan leads the Bowling Green Falcons, it's halftime of the Kraft MAC Women's Tournament Championship game. Dave Weekly, Demi Leonard back at courtside. Thankfully, the mascots have left, and you're back out here, Debbie. Let's go ahead and take a look at the highlights of our first half of action.
There was a lot of action, and most of it in the interior for both of these basketball teams. Ulfer starts the game off great for Eastern Michigan, and Coach Susie Merchant scoring inside. Some positive stuff early, too, for Allie Mann and Bowling Green. You see Mann on the backdoor cut. One of the few outside shots that Ryan Coleman's got to take this afternoon, but she hits that one. Then rebounded by Horn, who came off the bench and scored 10 points for Bowling Green. And Nikki Knapp just had a tremendous half for Eastern Michigan.
Our stats brought to us this afternoon by Cleveland Clinic, and Bowling Green shot the ball very poorly early in the first half, but they've raised their percentage.
They certainly have, and remember this, Bowling Green is a second half basketball team. They have been all season long.
All right, our second half is coming up. We'll have more comments about the mascot game as well, or maybe not. We're back in a moment from the gun.
Michigan University has garnered nationwide attention for its innovative work in breaking down barriers to learning. We tout the best of collegiate educators teaching real-world curriculums. Combined with $200 million in recent improvements to the Eastern Michigan campus, they ensure our graduates a learning edge well into the 21st century. Eastern Michigan University, after 150 years, still forging learning frontiers.
Kraft Mac Women's Tournament Championship Game is brought to you by Huntington Banking, Investments, Insurance. By First Energy, our energy is working for you. GMAC, the financial services people from General Motors. Office Max, you supply the ambition, we'll supply everything else. Kraft, the title sponsor of the 2004 Kraft Mac Women's Basketball Tournament. MBNA, the official credit card of the Mac. By the Cleveland Clinic, and by Giant Eagle. Make every day taste better. Second half coming up for the MAC Women's Championship game. 32-24 Eastern Michigan with the lead. Dave Weekly, Demi Leonard back safely behind the table here at courtside. Okay, here's Fred Flintstone with the cap during the game. And then it revealed... What is up with
the
Fred?
Ultimate turnover. He lost his hair. He lost his cap. He needs something back there.
Wow. I did get a kiss from him, though.
Did you?
Yeah.
Well, Fred is a beast in low block, but until next season, Sugar Bear's got to bulk up. He was outmatched on the court today. That was
Zippy
embarrassing.
Zippy was sick, though. Zippy.
Ugh. All right, back to the game. Eastern Michigan, balanced scoring. They had five double-figure scores in their semifinal win yesterday. They got good balance today as well. Ryan Coleman with a rebound for Eastern Michigan. So here come the Eagles with a chance to get that lead up to double digits. Just to do a bit of a reset. Bowling Green is in the championship game for the first time since 1994. They've won six games in a row. Eastern Michigan is in the championship game for the first time in school history. The winner of this game will go to the NCAA tournament. Man down the lane. Had the ball knocked away, and the Eagles will have it back.
Allie Mann asking, saying, hey, wasn't that ball deflected there? Wasn't that a block shot? Give somebody a stag. Give them a block shot and give us the ball back. I think we'll see both teams playing, mixing up the defenses once again, but Bowling Green was so much more successful in the zone in that first half. And I'm sure the assistant coaches and Kurt Miller got together and said, hey, we've got to go through a little bit more of the zone as long as we can shadow Frank.
Ford to Coleman for three. Got it.
Oh, the zone buster, though, makes them pay.
Coleman now with 7 points. Knapp leads Eastern Michigan today with eight.
Marion Crandall guarding Lindsey Austin. And once again, I think we'll see Austin being posted up down low. And
ball belongs to Eastern Michigan. Here's another look at Coleman.
Bowling Green going back to the zone. It was most successful. This will bring him out of it. Ryan Coleman squaring those shoulders, hitting that three-point shot with ease.
Ulker looking the wrong way, and Coleman nearly had the save.
Now that's the kind of, you know, error that drives coaches crazy. An unforced error. You hear that in tennis all the time. That's an unforced error in basketball. No excuse for that. Allie Mann really just cannot get it going in this basketball game so far, but credit Eastern's defense. When the ball goes inside, you're going to see four or five white shirts around. Good drive, though, in that particular play. Bowling Green's got to get one of these runs started here, and I think early in the half.
Lindsey Austin playing with two personal fouls, the basket. She's 2 of 7 from the field with 4 points. Here's Crandall's first three of the day. Puts it in.
And that's the one player. If they go to the zone, and again, in the first half, the zone was so much more successful. That's what Kurt Miller's done. It was a good adjustment, but you've got the stars. You got Coleman hitting one. You got Crandall coming out and hitting one, and that'll take them back to the man-to-man defense, and that'll get them back in the ball game if Lindsey Austin can hit those shots in the second half.
Austin was able to curl around the screen by man and knock in her second bucket in as many trips. 10-point lead. Holker inside. Man cut her off at the baseline. Austin nearly had a steal. She had three in yesterday's win over top-seeded Miami. Ford the pull-up and put it right in.
Really nice job. I just can't say enough about the performance of Erica Ford in this basketball tournament.
Bowling Green trailed by eight at the break. In yesterday's semifinal win, they trailed Miami by 15 points at halftime before coming all the way back. Honiger picks up her third foul, and she will go to the bench.
Honiger,
Kelly Kapfer back in.
Excuse me, Dave Honiger trying to set the screen, and Nikki Knapp, you know, Nikki Knapp, so strong, such a strong player, and a really good, you know, she could probably win an award, at least get a nomination for a Grammy or something. That kid, she knows how to play these refs.
She had a very good first half, 8 points and five rebounds. Second team All-MAC selection, Crandall, a little short and offline with that three attempt. Wenzel chases it down for Bowling Green. BG only one of seven from outside the arc so far today. They trail by 12. Kapfer made a tough catch and nearly made a tough shot. Ryan Coleman, the rebound for Eastern Michigan.
Kelly Kapfer.
Oh, what a great feed.
And once again, what great passing. You know, and Olker, again, she holds her position just long enough and releases off of her defender in time to catch the nice pass.
Olker's now got 8 points. Second assist for Coleman. Here's Allie Mann, the pump fake, and the shot off the glass up and good over Knapp.
That's what you want to do. Just slow and steady, get the ball inside, work that person, and there's the third foul of Lindsey Austin. Tried to pick Erica Ford, got a lot of Erica's body on the play and picks up the third, and that's huge.
Ford took one to the face, but right now, Kurt Miller and Bowling Green trailing Eastern Michigan by 12. Time in the CCA. Eastern Michigan leads Bowling Green by 12, just under 16 minutes to go in our second half in the MAC Women's Tournament Championship game. Lots of Falcon faithful made it over here to the gun for the game. Karin Horn, yeah, maybe she needed to get in the game a little bit earlier today,
yeah,
Debbie.
Yeah, you got to definitely think that that would have been something that Kurt Miller, as an athlete, is going, man, I should have had my freshman in. 10 points in the first half. Can play inside and outside, that young lady, and they really need to get something going. Remember, though, Bowling Green, they're a second-half team, but the key stat right now, above all, is the fact that Lindsey Austin has three fouls.
She's playing on the court with three fouls. She's number 12 in orange for Bowling Green. Knapp, again, she's in double figures now with 10.
Oh, great job, Nikki Knapp, just muscling her defender down even closer so she can lay the ball off the glass. Great play by her. And really, you got the defensive player of the year, Lindsey Austin, saddled with those fouls. I mean, that takes away a lot of her game. She gets a lot of points on offense off of her defense.
Mann rattles in the basket for Bowling Green. Bowling Green and Eastern Michigan going at it today in our final. This is the second consecutive year that two MAC West Division teams have squared off for the championship. Olker backs Mann down. Oh, Allie Mann with a great defensive play, and the possession arrow belongs to the Falcons. For the latest in MAC news, notes, and stats, plus multimedia and interactive features, visit the MAC website, mac-sports.com. While you're there, get your favorite school gear or MAC logo apparel by clicking on the online store on the left navigation bar. A credit card is required. Gear up for the MAC tournaments at the MAC online store. Horn up and in.
And that was a nice pass to the post that particular time. Nice lob pass, threw it high, threw it at the basket, and let the offensive player go get it.
Olker, back iron with a three attempt. Kapfer, is this the Bowling Green run? Wenzel, by Ford, and Coleman the steal.
Well, you got to love these quick hands, great anticipation by the Eastern Michigan team. There were probably three different players' hands on the ball that time.
Coleman now with four steals in this championship game. We talked about the defense of Lindsey Austin. Give it up for Coleman. She's had some terrific defensive plays today, too. Goes right by Horn, stepped on the line, and that's a turnover. Here comes Sarah Van Meter back into the game for Eastern Michigan. Nikki Knapp will take a well-deserved rest. She's been a big force today for the Eagles.
Yes, she certainly has. And, you know, causes a lot of contact on the inside, takes a lot of that contact back, and that can really wear you down.
Wenzel, would have cut the lead to 7. Crandall came out of there with it. Here's the pass ahead to Ford. Back to Crandall. That's a layup for her. Bang.
Good call, Dave. Knew that was going to happen. You could just see it in her eyes. She was getting the feet set as the ball was coming to her.
Crandall now with 6 points on the game. 2 of 3 from outside the arc. Eastern Michigan, a big story. Their ability to hit those three-pointers. And the Falcons have really gone cold from beyond the arc. Inside, that won't hang in there for Austin, but she'll go to the line for 2.
Not just their ability to hit the threes, but also their ability to take away the three-point opportunities from Bowling Green. Stephanie Wenzel has just not had the good look at the basket that she needs this afternoon.
Stephanie, how about Marion Crandall? I mean, she's one of the best three-point shooters in the nation, led the nation in three-point percentage for a large part of the year. But she doesn't force things. She just waits for her moment. And when she gets the ball and she's alone, it's 3.
Well, she lets the game come to her. And I tell you what, when you're a three-point shooter and you're working within that type of offense that runs so efficiently, they pass the ball so well, so you can bide your time because you know eventually the ball will come back to you in a place where you like to shoot.
She had 14 points in their semifinal victory over Marshall. And there's 4 members of the Eastern Michigan Eagles that earned all-conference honors. Crandall, the senior, was not one of them. But trust me, she's played a big role in their run to the finals today. Long pass ahead. Williams. And Williams is fouled by Lewis and will go to the line.
Bowling Green, that particular time, just not getting back on defense. Defensive transition, not good. Eastern Michigan likes to run the ball, and neither team has really been able to break out and use the running game the way they would like. But that particular time, nobody picking up the point guard from Eastern Michigan.
Williams knocks in the first one, the freshman from Mansfield Senior High School. Minutes plus left in our second half. Eastern Michigan by 13.
You know, in the runs that Bowling Green has had this season and will have often, they're started by that young lady who said, remember in the first half, we talked about the fact when they started their run against Miami, Honegger hit the three-point shot to begin it.
Honegger had
and
6.
And there's a good defensive play. Look at Knapp.
Knapp. Got her own follow-up and in, up over Honegger. Honegger really keyed that big 15-0 run yesterday against Miami. She had 6 steals in the game. She hit a big 3 a moment ago. We'll see what happens for the Falcons on this trip. Honegger with another look from outside the arc.
The other good thing about that, she's going to pull Knapp away from the basket when she's out there.
Austin offline with a 3. And there's an offensive foul inside against the Falcons.
Karen Horn, that particular play, you could see that she had, and she is so strong, she had Marion Crandall just with one hand holding her off.
Here's Lindsay Austin and what she's been up to since halftime. The nice lob inside. Horn was able to finish.
And that was a great pass. You know, these seniors, Wenzel and Austin, usually second half performers in this tournament so far. For instance, yesterday, 16 points in the first half, but the two of them scored 36 points in the second.
They were huge. Austin hits, spinning into the lane, shot it up and over Williams. She's got the height advantage in that matchup.
Exactly, I was going to say, got the size advantage there, and you could look and go to that.
Austin now with 10. She joins Horns, 12 in double figures.
Bowling Green, they change their man-to-man a little bit. They're playing more between the ball and the basket at this point in time. And that ball was so far in. How did it come back out?
Tough luck shot for Williams. Here's a chance for Bowling Green to get to within 8 or even 7 with a three-point attempt. They trailed by 8 at the break. Winner of this game goes to the NCAA tournament. Austin the follow-away offline. Van Meter the rebound.
Right now, I'm really surprised that Bowling Green's not going to the offensive boards more strongly, but the reason they're not doing it is because Eastern Michigan loves the ball, to run the ball so much, and their guards always can find those people. And, hey, Honegger says, Nikki Knapp
If you can get a Grammy Award, let me go for something, too. I want an Oscar. I want an Emmy.
Honegger saved the day. Great passing around in that half-court set by Eastern Michigan, but Knapp called for the offensive foul. 11:02 to go. Second half, Eastern Michigan by 10.
Start your Sunday with NASCAR This Morning. The only pre-race show
for Bowling Green. Nicky Knapp had a season-high 23 when the Eagles clinched the West by beating Central Michigan on March 2nd, and she's been huge again today.
Absolutely. Only 6 feet tall, but this young lady is so strong on the interior. Can take the contact from anyone in the league. Resilient. Goes back after the ball. Nicky Knapp. No napping from that young lady.
Nope. Dozen points today. 10 points in the semifinal win over Marshall. Susie Merchant knew she had something special in Nicky Knapp when Knapp scored 22 points and pulled down 18 boards in last year's season-opening win over Maryland Eastern Shore. Lewis to Mann, and Mann had the ball stripped by Coleman, and who's there but Horn to put it back up and in. That's a huge bucket for BG. They cut the lead to 8.
In the first half of this basketball game, the starters for Bowling Green only scored 12 points. Karen Horn had 10 just herself. She's really having a fine performance from Kurt Miller, but needs a little help from her friends. There's a double down.
Olker, and she's fouled by Honecker.
Well, there's good and bad in that particular situation. One, it's bad because Honecker, that's her fourth foul in the play. It's good because you got Olker going to the line and only a 27% free throw shooter.
She'll step up for 2 free throws. Hey, Debbie, you know, Kurt Miller's been saying it since the second half of the season that Bowling Green has been the feel-good story in women's basketball in the MAC all year long. And how about some love for Susie Merchant? They were picked 5th in the preseason poll in the West Division. They've come all the way to the championship game. They've won 11 out of their last 12. But there's only room for one name on the championship trophy.
Yep, so Mac's only going to get one invite like everyone else. I don't think the conference is going to get 2 this year. Maybe that's something for the future. But, Susie Merchant has done such a great job this team this year. Her team's no nonsense. They don't get very excited about anything. They just come out and they work it.
Austin. Off the pick. Line drive 3, back iron, no good. Capper tapped it to Mann. It wouldn't stay in there, and she'll go to the line for 2. So here's an opportunity with 2 converted free throws to get to within 6 for the Falcons.
The composure that we've been talking about, Eastern Michigan needs to keep it right now. And let's look at the 3-point field goal percentage. Eastern Michigan 6 of 15 and really taking away the good looks from Bowling Green. Bowling Green, a fine 3-point shooting team. Their post left to shoot the 3, and Eastern taking that away.
And that's our Giant Eagle stat flash. Knapp back into the game. Olker will exit, as will Williams. Ford back on the floor. Miss by Mann. The lead is 7. That's as close as Bowling Green has been in a while. As close. It was 16-9 in the first half. The last time BG trailed by 7.
And I'm sure this is the place in the game that Susie Merchant, she's talked to her team about this. She's told her team, hey, we're going to have to withstand a run. This is it. And look, they go to Van Meter.
Sarah Van Meter answers for Eastern Michigan to push that lead back out to 9. You know, yesterday, Eastern Michigan played Marshall. Marshall played many, many players. Debbie, Eastern Michigan essentially is going with 8 players. They played back-to-back games. They played 3 games in 4 days. At what point does fatigue start to set in for the Eagles?
You don't have fatigue. I don't care. This is a championship game. These kids are all less than 22 years old, and a lot of them are 18 and 19. You don't get tired of a championship game. You really got to give it all you've got. And this time of the year, most teams are playing, most coaches are using that 7 and 8 player rotation anyway.
Okay. Coleman now with 3 fouls. Austin had a great look at the basket and was able to get her hands on the rebound and keep the possession for Bowling Green.
Eastern, you know, if you look at the numbers over the season, they are the best defensive team
by number in the conference, and they're showing that this afternoon, really taking away what Bowling Green wants to do.
Well, Lewis had a terrific spin move, but maybe it's just a little bit too good, called as a travel.
Too much flash there, but again, Bowling Green trying to push the ball, trying to get something going. They need to do it with defense, though. Need to get a couple steals, get some points off their defense, get the run started that way.
BG shooting 37% from the field, just 2 of 11 from outside the arc.
And there's Nikki. She's too far away from the basket, but she's got... Oh.
And yeah. A travel is called on Knapp. I thought there was one step too many in there. Wenzel back in.
Nikki Knapp, known for her play on the block, and here she's outside. Doesn't really know what to do with the basketball here. How do you split that defender? And it's not by taking the extra step.
Well, yesterday in their comeback win from a double-digit deficit against Miami, it was the seniors that led the way for Bowling Green. We've got 8.5 minutes to go now. BG trails by 9. If the Falcons are going to make the comeback, who is going to lead it? Mann into the paint. Put it up and in.
Great play in two ways by Allie Mann. One, she gets the ball in the basket. That's more important. But secondly, she avoids the charge on the play by going straight up.
Mann starting to pile up the numbers now after a slow start. 12 points and 7 rebounds for the freshman of the year in the Mid-American Conference. Wenzel with a strip. Crandall. Missed that. You're playing with fire when you leave Crandall open like that.
You know that right now, Kurt Miller would love to get Stephanie Wenzel a great look at a three-point opportunity.
Horn has been instant offense. Here's Katfer off the window. And what a great time for her first basket of the game. It pulls BG to within 5.
Kelly Katfer, one of the seniors on this Bowling Green basketball team. She knows her role, and if you're going to win championships, you've got to have players who understand their role.
There's a lot of brown in this building, and they're starting to make some noise now. The Falcons in the midst of one of their patented tourney runs this week at the gun. Shot clock down to 5. Knapp, got to make it happen. Here come the Falcons with a chance to get a little closer. Austin with those 3 fouls. What a great look. Katfer was wide open and wasn't expecting the pass. Katfer couldn't finish, but the Falcons have come alive offensively. Allie Mann, the freshman of the year in the league. And Katfer off the window. Here comes Bowling Green down by 5. Michigan continues to lead Bowling Green, but the Falcons are getting closer. It's a 5-point game now with just under 7 minutes to go in our second half at Cleveland's Gund Arena. BG's in the midst of a 9-2 run over the last 5 minutes. Our Office Max leading scorers today for Bowling Green, the Falcons. Karin Horn leads the way with 14. Nikki Knapp has a dozen points for Eastern Michigan. Now, Eastern Michigan and Bowling Green, they played in this tournament 3 times previously. And last year, the Eagles knocked the Falcons out in the opening round. This afternoon, they're playing in the championship game. Coleman with a good look. Back iron, Crandall, the long rebound, and a fresh 30 for the Eagles.
Well, you are just playing with fire if you're going to leave Coleman and Crandall open like that for a 3-point shot opportunity.
Look inside, Katfer broke up that pass. Eastern Michigan able to keep possession. Shot clock under 10. Coleman with 7 points today.
Whoa.
Make it 9.
Man, that's a great in-your-face jump shot. Karin Horn right there, and Coleman knocking it down.
What a clutch bucket as we get down to cases. We turn under 6 minutes in our final. BG trailed by 8 at the break. They're down by 7 right now.
Look at Erica Ford. Has done such a great job when Stephanie Wenzel. Wenzel not any real good looks at the basket from 3-point land, and that's what she needs. And they also need some offensive rebounding.
Horn couldn't hit the jumper off the baseline. Eastern Michigan's got the ball back, an opportunity to burn a little bit more time. Lindsay Austin's on the floor, number 12 in orange. She's hit buzzer-beating winners in the last 2 games for the Falcons against Western Michigan and Miami, but she's got to get into position. to make the game-winning shot, and there she committed her fourth personal foul.
Tell you, Ryan Coleman, watch it come off the screen right here. Look at Karin Horn right there in your face, jump shot, sticks it. That's why this kid, I'm telling you, she can be the best player in the mat next year if she keeps that own switch to the own position.
Honegger back into the game. Lewis will replace Horn, and just a correction, Austin has three fouls, not four.
Isolation play here, and watch him run some clock. Golden Green back to his own defense, though, and that's been, again, in the first half, it was very, very good for them to go to the zone. She's got to find Crandall, got to know where she is, and can't get lazy with your passes.
Look at those hands by Golden Green. Finally, it's Wenzel with the steal. Four to beat, and she does.
Really nice concentration under pressure there for Stephanie Wenzel to hit that. And again, we talked about them getting points off their defense. That's going to ignite this crowd. I bet they get another steal here.
Bowling Green now back within five. Van Meter, the sixth man of the year, to Coleman. And Coleman is fouled, and it'll be Lewis on the personal.
Well, I bet you they go for another steal at least at that point. And Lewis, just a little too much contact there. Keys to the game. We talked about Bowling Green getting some points off defense and timing their runs. They haven't done the first, but this run that they had started at least, Eastern Michigan has answered just about every possession. I think there's still one to come.
Coleman steps up. Seventh team foul. Here's the 1-1. She didn't even touch the rim. Coleman struggled early, is just 3 of 9 from the field, but has battled back 10 points now and 7 boards. 2 of 3 at the line.
She's just so steady. And again, look at that face. You know, no excitement. And again, that's this no-nonsense approach that Susie Merchant takes with her basketball team. They listen to her in practice. There's not a lot of, handshaking and rousing around. Just a lot of hard work.
Honegger could not hit that three. Austin nearly was able to get her hand on the outlet pass. Ford controls it. Eastern Michigan has the ball, a 7-point lead. They're a little over 4 minutes away from their first MAC women's tourney title. Backdoor feed, Crandall the finish. What a great pass by Ford.
Boy, and talk about efficiency. That's just great, basic basketball. The senior times are cut perfectly. Goes to the basket. And Ford delivers once again, nice pass.
Ford, 5 assists here in the championship game this afternoon. The lead is 9. Horn, a huge shot for BG. They had to have it, and they get a quick timeout. It's a 2-possession game. Bowling Green back to within 6. 3:39 to go in our second half. Eastern Michigan leads. The Falcons of Bowling Green trying to make another run. They trail by 6. It's 59-53. Bowling Green has been as close as 5 here in the second half. The lead now is 6. 3:39 left to go second half. And the hardware is in the house. That is the MAC Tournament Championship Trophy. It'll go to one of these two teams. Now Kurt Miller, 21 wins this year. Susie Merchant also with 21 wins. Both of these coaches would desperately like to tack one more victory on, and the second highest crowd ever for the MAC Women's Championship game. More than 4,800 at Gund Arena in Cleveland this afternoon. Van Meter down the lane with a right hand.
Oh, really nice take by the freshman Van Meter coming through for a team when they need her.
And if you're thinking about three-point goals to get BG back in the game, they've struggled in that category today. Just 3 of 13 beyond the arc. Horn down the lane. And that will send Horn to the line, and it will stop the clock. 3:05 to go in the second.
A little confusion out there about who receives this foul, but watch the defender come in. Nikki Knapp gets her feet set. Karin Horn charges into her. Great call by the official.
We'll step away from the gun momentarily and come back for the finish. Eastern Michigan leads by 8.
You Spartan show that reveals sports' most dramatic stories. Jeremy Bloom battles the NCAA to keep his Olympic dreams alive. Plus, will diabetes sideline Gonzaga's title shot? Fox Sports Net across America, premieres Sunday.
Well, the Falcons of Bowling Green have climbed so many mountains this week at the gun, but they still have one more mountain to climb. And, Debbie, let's revisit our Eastern Michigan Keys.
Well, when you think about Eastern Michigan, they've done a great job of withstanding the run. We knew Bowling Green would try to come back in this basketball game, but Eastern Michigan has held the lead the entire game. They've withstood the run each time. When you look at the defensive rebounds, however, you know, they're minus six in that category, as is Eastern Michigan. But the problem for Bowling Green, they haven't been able to convert those offensive rebounds into points.
Ryan Coleman with the basketball, 11 points today. Knapp leads the Eagles with a dozen. Ford down to the baseline. To Knapp, spinning, shot blocked, rebounded by Honiger. Knapp got it back. And a fresh 30 for Eastern Michigan. That's huge.
Well, I'll tell you what, Nikki Knapp has been the woman in this particular basketball game. Hands all over the place. That was a huge, huge offensive rebound or pickup, whatever you want to call it.
Crandall
Green staying in the zone, though, Dave. Little surprise.
Crandall with an opportunity for a three. They want to run more time. Here's Coleman.
Don't foul.
Ooh. Ford in and out. Lindsey Austin knocked to the floor by Knapp. Just the fifth team foul on Eastern Michigan. And, of course, Lindsey Austin hit the game winner in the quarterfinals against Western Michigan to knock out the defending champs of this tournament. Then another buzzer beater yesterday against the top seed Miami. She's got the ball now, right now, for the Falcons of Bowling Green. We've turned under 2 minutes. Here's Allie Mann. Left that one short. Rebounded by Van Meter.
Great board by Van Meter. Huge miss there by Bowling Green. Bowling Green's going to have to come out and play a little man-to-man now. They're going to have to think about with this type of deficit, when do you foul and who do you foul?
Well, Coleman draws the foul from Horn. Coleman, 3 of 4 at the line this afternoon. Eastern Michigan, 7 of 13 from the line today as a team.
And not great free throw shooters, but Ryan Coleman, the best on the squad at 75%.
Horn, that's her fifth personal foul. Horn leaves the game with a game-high 17 points, 7 of 10 from the field today. An outstanding game, but she's finished for the afternoon. BG calls a timeout. They have two left. Eastern Michigan has four timeouts remaining.
What the Bowling Green has got to do, one, obviously they got to score some baskets. But then if they do indeed score, there are some players on this Eastern Michigan team that they can foul and who just do not have very good percentages. Crandall is only a 53% free throw shooter.
Hey, Mac fans, go along with the MBNA Mac MasterCard. Call toll-free, 866-GET-MBNA now to apply for a Mac MasterCard and get a Mac Spectator chair free with their first qualifying transaction of $25. Toll-free, it's 866-GET-MBNA. Be sure to mention the priority code. Do it with me together, Debbie.
QJQ4.
Coleman at the line. This is a 1-1.
This could be the game.
Would not stay in there. Honiger the rebound. Here comes Bowling Green. Time running down. They trail by 8. Still a 3-possession game. Inside the turn. Honiger right in front of the rim. Couldn't hit. And a foul on the Falcons.
And that's the second freshman that's going to foul out of this basketball game. Honiger on the miss there. And then over the back, trying to secure the rebound. See Nikki Knapp playing behind on the play. Honiger just not quite strong enough to get it up, and obviously coming over the back of Nikki Knapp.
So Honiger has joined Horn among the list of Falcons who have fouled out of this championship game. She was so big in the win over Miami in the semifinals yesterday. Today had 8 rebounds, but only 3 points. And Bowling Green, they have gone cold offensively absolutely the wrong time. They have not scored any points in the last 2 minutes and 21 seconds.
And they've been getting opportunities in the paint and just have not been able to convert them. Nikki Knapp, did you see Honegger going to the bench? And boy, what a great career she's going to have for Kurt Miller at Bowling Green. But Nikki Knapp, this sophomore who certainly not any shows of any sophomore slump out of her this year. Knapp just so strong, undersized, but what a great performance in this tournament.
Nikki Knapp is our Huntington Bank player of the game. She missed both free throws, held ball situation, and the arrow points to Eastern Michigan. So Eastern Michigan had Coleman at the line. She missed the front end of the one and one. Knapp missed two free throws, but they got the ball back.
Certainly did.
There have been no points scored in this game by either team in the last 2 minutes and 18 seconds.
Okay, 8 down in a minute and 5 seconds to play or so. You've got to think about putting them on the line. You've got to have some action here.
Now you're down to almost 10 seconds on the shot clock. As we go inside of a minute to go. And finally, a foul is called with 7 seconds left on the 30-second shot clock.
Just, God, you hate to see it. And if you're going to foul when there's 30 seconds, 29, 28 seconds, not with 7.
So Ford will step up after Coleman missed the front end of the 1-1, and Knapp missed the pair.
Erica Ford, 69% free throw shooter, and you know what? They're doing what Bowling Green wants them to do. They're missing, but Bowling Green's got to rebound the basketball, come down and score.
Even if she makes this one, it'll still be a 3-possession game. The time now ticking away. Ford rattles in 1 of 2. The lead is 9.
And I'm sure right now there's a little bit of token pressure there to make Bowling Green dribble the ball in the backcourt.
Austin couldn't get that line drive 3 attempt to go. Coleman trying to avoid the foul in the backcourt. Precious seconds ticking away. And Coleman finally fouled, 39.7 on the clock.
And Eastern Michigan, again, they have been so efficient. I know I keep saying that word, but that is the word to describe them. Just great performance this afternoon. Great passing, great cuts to the basket.
Here's our first energy play of the game.
Erica Ford doing a great job. And Marion Crandall, the right timing, making that backdoor cut. That just shows you what a good passing team this is. What great timing they have within their offenses. Again, no nonsense, just get the job done.
That was our first energy play of the game. Ford with a backdoor feed to Crandall. Coleman, who's drawn 5 fouls today, steps up and hits a pair. And what a season it's been for Eastern Michigan. Final seconds ticking away. And the ball belongs to the Eagles. Kurt Miller going to call one of his 2 remaining timeouts right here with 30.5 seconds to go. BG now without managing a point up on the board in the last 3 minutes.
That's you know what? They've got some good looks, as we said before. But Kurt Miller, that timeout, you know, he's 11 points down in this basketball game. His team is 30 seconds to play. That's as much for these freshmen just to teach them about, hey, this is going to happen to us again. We're going to be in a championship game again. This is what we're going to do now, and it's what we're going to do in the future.
Well, Cleveland rocks in Cleveland, and they have absolutely done that this week. They came in as the 2nd seed behind top-seeded Miami.
You know, most teams, Dave, when they come on the court off of a timeout, 30 seconds to go, it's the championship game of your conference tournament, and not a smile on a face. They're still working.
And there's a foul. Mann fouls Ford. Will go to the other end and shoot some more free throws. Eastern Michigan now in the double bonus. How bad has it been for Bowling Green offensively in their last 6 possessions? They're 0-for-4 from the field with 2 turnovers. This was a 6-point game, 59-53, with just over 4 minutes to go. But the offense for Kurt Miller has just not been here down the stretch.
Erica Ford again, this Eastern Michigan team, if there's a little clink in the armor, it might be the free throw shooting. Really need to improve that next season.
Well, Eastern Michigan continues to miss the free throws. Bowling Green's 21 wins. That was the total of their wins the previous two seasons combined. They were the most improved team in MAC women's basketball this year. But it looks like this day is going to be a special day for Eastern Michigan in the finals for the first time in school history, and now less than 15 seconds away from the championship and a berth in the NCAA tournament. Wenzel, finally, and a timeout, the last timeout for the Falcons.
Well, you know what? If that's the last three-pointer she takes, though, in her career, it's great. It's outstanding that she hit that one. Stephanie Wenzel has had an excellent career for Bowling Green. What a season this team has had. What great leadership out of Lindsey Austin and Stephanie Wenzel all season long, to be playing with three freshmen on the court at all times. Can be nerve-wracking, but they've been great leaders.
Well, Wenzel and Austin combined for 36 points in the second half in their upset yesterday of top-seeded Miami. Today, the two senior guards. Wenzel has 10 points, but just 3 of 12 from the field. Lindsey Austin, the last second star of the two wins over Western Michigan and Miami, 10 points, but 4 of 14. They just didn't have it today.
And, you know, you were seeing Stephanie Wenzel just a little while ago. And what do you say about being first team All-American?
Academic. Amazing.
First team academic All-American. That is huge. Eastern Michigan, though, they're going to be a formidable opponent for someone when you start thinking about the NCAA tournament and who they're going to probably play. You know, traditionally, this committee has sent the MAC out to the West. I'm thinking that's probably going to happen again. Maybe a 13 seed, a 14 seed, likely 13 or 14, no higher than that for sure. But, hey, they don't care who they play. They're just happy to be in it, and you better believe they'll be prepared. Susie Merchant just doing a fine job this year.
We'll head back down to the other end, shoot a couple more free throws. 10.9 seconds remaining.
Bowling Green foul number 12, Lindsey Austin.
Lindsey Austin committed the foul, her fourth. Eastern Michigan has hit just 3 of their last 9 free throws. And for, no, check that, Austin, that is her fifth, so she becomes the third Falcon to foul out, joining Honegger and Horn among Falcons disqualified today in this championship game by fouls.
Been superwoman so many times for her basketball team. Just Eastern Michigan must have had a little kryptonite in their pockets today, because Austin just could not get it done. Free throw shooting needs to be improved, Eastern Michigan. I'm sure it will be.
Well, you can see those Eagles can't wait to get on the court and celebrate the first MAC tournament championship in school history. And a lot of the fans have made the trip over here from Ypsilanti, and they're ready to celebrate. Lewis. Thorburn had her shot blocked by Coleman. And Coleman is alone, and she holds the ball as the game ends. Eastern Michigan defeats Bowling Green 65-56 to win the 2004 Kraft MAC Women's Basketball Tournament Championship.
There's some emotion. There's a grin.
Susie Merchant, in her sixth season, takes Eastern Michigan to its first MAC tournament championship game and wins the championship in the process, defeating Bowling Green 65-56. So the Eagles of Eastern Michigan, they're finished here at the gun, but they have at least one more game to go. They are on their way to the NCAA tournament. Eastern Michigan finished the year red hot. They've won 12 of their last 13 games, including their run to the championship here at the Gund in Cleveland. Debbie standing by with the head coach of the Eastern Michigan Eagles, Susie Merchant.
Here with a very happy Susie Merchant. And coach, by the looks on your face in that entire basketball game, it was like you were just getting down to business, really not trying to get your team scattered at all. Great performance, very efficient.
Yeah, I was really proud of our kids. You know, this is such an emotional moment. And we kept saying in the locker room that this is an emotional moment, but what's gotten us to this point has been calm, poised, and just play. It's still just a basketball game. Win or lose, it's still a game.
Absolutely, Coach. Tell me about the performance of Nikki Knapp this afternoon.
Well, that was huge. She hasn't been playing very well, and Nikki's one of those kids, sometimes when she gets in a rut, sometimes she doesn't step out of it. So we were really excited to see her play well. We thought we could really establish an inside presence today against their post players.
Well, you certainly did that, and Coach, we want to say good luck to you in this NCAA tournament.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
Back to you, Dave.
Congratulations, Susie Merchant and Eastern Michigan. And down the stretch, their defense was huge. Bowling Green scored only 3 points in the last 3 minutes and 42 seconds. For Eastern Michigan, Ryan Coleman led the way with 14. Nikki Knapp had 12 points for the Eagles. Karin Horn had 17 to lead Bowling Green. So for my partner, Debbie Leonard, this is Dave Weekly saying so long from the Gund Arena in Cleveland, Ohio, where Eastern Michigan has defeated Bowling Green 65-56 to win the Kraft Mac Women's Basketball Tournament Championship. Next up for the Eagles, it's the NCAA Tournament. We say so long from Northeast Ohio.